Only a few days to go for your exams? Are you feeling stressed? Are you feeling nervous? Are you feeling anxious? Do you feel like crying all the time? Congratulations, you are normal. And the one who claims to not be scared during exam times? Jhoot bol raha hai wo. So hi guys, it's Dr. Parth Palan here from KM Hospital, Mumbai. And today, I'm going to give you 7 tips to deal with your exam stress. So let's begin. Point number 1. Timetable. You know what is the major reason for your stress right now? Time. Arre time hi nahi hai humare paas. Time is so less and the syllabus to cover for the exam is so vast. How do we cover? The answer is very simple. Consider yourself lucky because the people with whom you're competing also have the same syllabus and the same stipulated time. So it's up to you guys how you utilize your time. And timetables for me have been really, really helpful because see, for example, there are 10 days left for exam. So understood that 2 days before that particular paper, you are going to study for that paper itself. But for those 8 days, what you're going to do is in your hands. So you make sure that for the next 2 days, you study one subject, for the other, you study another subject. That is up to you. But when your timetable is made, you have a specific system in your mind. You know that, okay, now this I have to study like that, after that, next subject, after that, the other subject. So then what you do is the fear of the unknown, the fear that the portion will not get completed, or the fear that, you know, you'll not be able to properly finish your whole syllabus in this much amount of time goes away. So timetables are really very, very important. Point number 2, your day schedule, which means your day's timetable. So in your day's timetable, make sure first you devote that certain amount of time to your sleep itself. What you're going to do is, see, for sleep, everyone says 8 hours is very important. But guys, I know that 8 hours is just too much to ask from you all. But 6 hours at the same time is very less. So I'll give you the beach ka answer. 7 hours. 7 hours is a good enough time for sleep. So first in your day's timetable, 7 hours are gone for sleep. That you decide yourself. 1 to 8 or 12 to 7 you're going to sleep. That is up to you. So sleep is done. Now we have time for the day. Now we have time to study and the break time. So how you're going to do is, any ideal situation, after every 2 to 3 hours of study time, 15 to 20 minutes break is fine. All of this is really personal, but what I want to stress here is not how much time your break is what you exactly do in your break time. So in your break time, you close your eyes, you meditate, you draw, you paint, you listen to music, you interact with your parents, you talk a little, but don't use social media. Social media is a very, very big distraction, which brings me to the next point, the third point, which is distraction. Social media is your worst enemy in the last few days of your exam because it wastes your precious time. It gives strain to your eyes, which gives you headache. And third, and the most important, it plays with your mind. What you do with social media, that is after social media, what you will do is you will think about that Instagram reel while studying, which is going to waste your time again. What more you're going to do is you're going to feel sad because you saw your other friend's post who's enjoying there in Manali, and here you're studying for an exam. So it unknowingly, it's a vicious cycle. It plays with your mind. So it drains your energy. It's not relaxing, guys. Social media is not relaxing during exam time. It drains your energy. And break time is only and only for relaxing both your mind and your body. So no means no social media. Point number 4, surround yourself with positive energy, by which I mean stay away from negative energy. People who break you, people who criticize you, people who misguide you. You know, everybody has those friends who in the last days of exam will call you and say, kitna hua? Kitna hua bhai? Bata de, kitna? Padha kya? Maine to kuch nahi padha. Chal, saath mein fail honge. That's a lie. That's a complete lie. They are just trying to waste your time. And then, if your friends were not enough, then there are these aunties and uncles who ask you hundreds of questions. Oh, beta, kidhar hai exam? Kabhi hai exam? Exam ke baad ka kya plan hai? Vacation mein kahan jaoge? Beta, shaadi kab hai? So, please stay away from the relatives. You make sure you give your phone to your mom or your dad and make sure that all the relatives, and tell your mom that not to give any of these relatives' phone to you so that you don't fall in this trap, guys. Point number 5, inspire yourself. You know, fill your study table with all the inspiring quotes and all the positive vibes. Yes, I can. Yes, I will. Keep saying this to yourself very often. And another thing, what you can do is on your flannel board, just make a calendar till the last date of your exam And every night after you're done with studying, just cross or tick mark or do whatever, but just cross the date so that you exactly know that aaj 10 days, tomorrow 9 days, after which I'll be free. And keep thinking about the reward, because when you think about the reward, it inspires you to work, you know. When you think about, oh, in the vacation I'll be going to Maldives ka beach. So that is an inspiration in itself, that you're waiting for the reward. And when you want the reward so badly, you'll make sure that you work harder. Point number 6, study smart. In the last few days of your exam, make it a point that you only and only read the most important stuff. You read the high yield stuff. You know that toppers are not the ones who know the most. They're not the ones who read the whole textbook. Toppers are the ones who keep revising the high yield and the important stuff again and again. Understand the difference, guys. You can also do it. And what I would recommend to you is that you make a separate notebook only for all the volatile stuff. Like, you know, those tables and charts, jo kehte hai na, wo last day pe revision karna hi padta hai uska. So you make a separate book for that, so that in the last 2 days, you only and only read that, the volatile stuff. That is very important. And now, the 7th point. The most important point. Don't compare yourself with others. You are unique. Understand that. Let that sink in. Don't set unrealistic goals. See, getting inspired is absolutely fine. In fact, it's really good. But you know, when you're not able to achieve those unrealistic expectations, getting depressed after that is absolutely not fine at all. You'll have so many exams in your life, guys. Can you imagine? You have 10th, you have 12th, you have entrances, then you'll have degree exam, then you'll have interviews. And your whole life is an exam. So you need to be calm. You need to be prepared. You need to be confident. And you know what is confidence? Confidence is not knowing the answers to all the questions. No, that is not confidence. Confidence is being prepared. Is being prepared to face each and every question with calmness. It's being prepared for each and every question that you have read. You know that, okay, this is the question I have read. So you calmly go, you write your answer, you tick mark. That is confidence. And that is the most important thing, guys, to reduce your exam anxiety. So be calm and whatsoever, never give up. And now, I have a small message for your parents. Yeah, right now, please pass the phone to them. Hi, it's Dr. Parth Palan here. So this is the time you need to support your child rather than scaring him. He's already scared of the exams, scared of uncertainty, scared that he'll fail, scared that he'll fail you, scared that he'll lower your image in this society. Your child needs you the most right now. So please spend time with him. Please talk to him. Please spend as much time as possible with him. Tell him that everything is gonna be fine. That it's just an exam. It's not the end of the world. Be calm. That's all you need to tell him. And guys, if you're shy and really scared to show this to your parents, let me tell this to you. I'm there with you. Don't worry, guys. Everything's gonna be fine. It's just an exam. Be calm. Yes, you can. I believe in you. You will do it. Absolutely. All the best, guys. All the best. Kill it. And if you have any doubts whatsoever, please leave it in the comment section below and I'll try my best to answer them for you. And please share this video with as many students as possible, because I'm very sure it's gonna benefit them. And then the purpose of making this video shall be fulfilled for me. Thank you so much, guys. All the very best. Kill it.